Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship today. Again, a beautiful summer day. Not quite summer yet, I think. A few days ago, but it was a beautiful day. Just to introduce myself as Pastor Doug Paulson. I know many of you with your faces here, and I serve as director for Clipboard's Ministry of Seafarers at nine, and at nine as campus pastor at UMD. So thank you to this congregation. I want to be sure to say that you do support those ministries, and it's a real blessing to be able to provide ministry of hospitality to the seafarers on the international ships, and to also be a welcoming place for students to live out their faith while they're working on their degrees. I also want to thank Emily Rotten for playing today. She had to do that. And, we'll have some announcements later, of course, so would you please stand for the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life. And feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy, you are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen. Let us join in our opening hymn, Built on the Rock, number 652.
Amen.
trust in you, that we may triumph over all evil in the strength of the same Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you. A life lived for the sake of the kingdom of God,
These people were viewed as outsiders. Jesus challenged the norms about who's in and who's outside the realm of God's grace. He's been forgiving and healing all who are in need, everyone, no exceptions. Not only was Jesus forgiving and healing, he was, as I mentioned to the kids this morning, he was also redefining family. In a time when family was everything, where children took care of parents and grandparents and everybody stayed very close together, Jesus needed to take some time to redefine that. Say that those who do the will of God, people who live out the gospel in their lives, are his true brothers and sisters and mother. It's not surprising that what Jesus was saying and doing caused even his own family to want to get him under control. But we shouldn't be too quick to judge Jesus' family. There were reasons for them to be concerned. They were concerned about what Jesus was teaching and doing. Jesus was saying things like, don't resist an evil person, but whoever slaps you on the right cheek, turn the other to him also. Or Jesus' statement that the greatest among you will be your servant. Those that the world called people of no account, Jesus called blessed. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who are merciful and compassionate. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for God's righteousness and justice. Blessed are those who work for peace. To a lot of people, those ideas not only sounded crazy, but impractical and impossible. And yet, Jesus calls us to be crazy enough, to love like Jesus, to give like Jesus, to forgive like Jesus, to be inclusive like Jesus, to do justice, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with God like Jesus. As Bishop Michael Curry of the Episcopalian Church says, we need some Christians who are crazy enough to dare to change the world from the nightmare it often is with something closer to the dream that God dreams for it. After the death of Steve Jobs, one of the founders of Apple Computers, a commercial from the 1990s went viral on the internet. In the commercial, they showed a collage of photographs and film footage of people who have invented and inspired, created and sacrificed to make a difference in the world. As the images roll by, the voice reads a poem that begins, "Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square hole." We can paraphrase the poem to say that the Christians who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. I agree with Bishop Curry when he says that we need some crazy Christians. Christians crazy enough to believe that God is real and that Jesus lives. Crazy enough to follow the radical way of the gospel. Crazy enough to believe that the love of God is greater than all the powers of evil and death. In one of my wife's trips to India, she met and traveled with Sister Lucy. Sister Lucy, an Indian Catholic nun, appeared a little crazy because with no finances, she began taking in women and children who were escaping violence from their family situation. It didn't matter if they were Muslim, or Hindu, or Christian. Sister Lucy wanted to provide a place of safety and care. From that small beginning, United Nations, where she has been called the modern-day Mother Teresa. Sister Lucy has no financial means and no particular skills. She is just someone crazy enough to believe that the love of God is greater than the powers of evil and death. To a lot of people, it's crazy to say that God loves everyone the same, because this just isn't how the world works. To a lot of people, it's crazy to think we could have enough food, enough decent housing, and enough safe water and adequate health care for everyone.
Thank you.
Receive our prayers, O God, and come quickly to our aid, through the power of the Spirit and the love of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Share that peace with one another.
Thank you.
Thank you.
received from your table more than we could ever ask. And as you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen.
Receive the benediction. The blessing of God provides for us, feeds us, and journeys